Hello students, in today's lecture we are going to discuss about moment of inertia of a thin rod about an axis passing through its center and perpendicular to its length. So we have to calculate the moment of inertia. Suppose this is an thin uniform rod and we have to find out the moment of inertia of this rod about an axis passing through its center. So the axis of rotation, it is passing through its center. So for such a rod which is thin and uniform, its geometrical center and its center of mass is at the same point. Suppose this is the axis of rotation which is passing through its center, and this axis of rotation, it is perpendicular to its length. Now we have to determine the moment of inertia of this rod about this axis which is passing through the center of the rod. Suppose capital L, it is the length of this rod, and capital M, it is the mass of this rod, and this axis of rotation, it is exactly passing through its center. So we have to find out the moment of inertia of this rod about this axis which is passing through the center and perpendicular to the length of the rod. So how we can find out the moment of inertia of such thin and uniform rod about an axis passing through its center and perpendicular to its length? So for that purpose we have to consider, that is, suppose this is the rod, this is the thin and uniform rod having the total length, suppose capital L, it is the length of rod, and suppose capital M, it is the mass of, that is, the rod. Now the axis of rotation, it is passing through its center. Suppose this is the center, that is the O, and this is the axis of rotation, or this is the axis which is passing through the center of this rod. Suppose C, it is the center, and rod, it is performing rotational motion about this axis. Okay, then if capital L, it is the length, then we can say that this length, it is the L/2, and this length, it is the L/2, but we can say that it is minus L/2, and this is, that is, the plus L/2. So this is the separation of, that is, the rod due to this axis of rotation. Due to the axis of rotation, rod, it is separated into exactly two parts. Okay, so how we can determine the moment of inertia? In general, we know that moment of inertia, it is nothing but the moment of inertia, it is the summation of, that is, m, that is, r i square. But this rod, it is the continuous, and the mass within this rod, it is continuously distributed. So for that purpose we can use the integration one, and we can determine the moment of inertia by using the integration, that is, integration of, that is, the m into the distance. But to determine the total moment of inertia of this rod, we have to consider a small element. Suppose this is the small element in this rod having the, that is, the thickness, suppose the dx, and it is at distance, suppose x, from the axis of rotation, and having the very small mass, that is the dm. Okay, so dm, that indicates the small mass for the small part. Dx, it is the thickness of the small part of the rod, and x, it is the distance of the small part, distance from axis of rotation, So how we can determine the total moment of inertia? We know that this rod, it is made up from the small elements having the mass, small mass, that is the dm. So dm, it is the very small mass of this rod. So first of all, we have to determine the moment of inertia of this small mass, that is the dm. And then we can determine the total moment of inertia of this rod, because we know that this rod, it is made up from such small elements. So we can write like this, the total moment of inertia, that is I equals to integration of total mass, that is m, and that is the x square, we can say that, the distribution of the mass. So for that purpose, to determine the total moment of inertia, first of all, we have to determine the moment of inertia of this, that is the small element, and that can be calculated by using this. Suppose di, it is the small moment of inertia of this small part, that is di equals to, that is mass of this small element dm into, that is the x square, it is the distance of this small part from the axis of rotation. Okay, so this is the moment of inertia of this small part, but this rod, it is made up from such small parts. So we can determine the total moment of inertia, total moment of inertia of rod about an axis passing through the center and perpendicular to its length. It is given by integrating this equation. So on integrating equation number 1, we can determine the total moment of inertia, and therefore integration of, that is dr, equals to integration of dm into, that is the x square. Then what is the dm, that is the mass for small element? We know that the mass, it is given by, we can determine the density like this, density equals to, that is mass per unit volume, when you consider the cubical vessel one. We can determine the density, mass per unit area, when you consider the surface area, or the mass is distributed on the surface area. But in this case, mass is distributed over the length of this rod, and therefore the density of this rod, it is given by density equals to mass per unit length. So the mass of this small element, it can be calculated by using the formula, that is mass of small element equals to its density into, that is the thickness, and thickness, it is, that is the dx. So it is the mass. So density into, that is the thickness, it is the mass for that element. So you can write like this, integration of, that is dI equals to integration of dm, it is nothing but the density, but density, it is the mass per unit length into thickness, that is the dx, and this x square as it is. Now on integrating, by using the limits, we have to integrate this one, but we are having the limits from minus L by 2 to plus L by 2. That means we are going to consider the total rod, and for that purpose the limits are minus L by 2 up to, that is the plus, that is L by 2. These are the limits of, that is the integration. Okay, so integration of di, it is nothing but the capital I. So that is the total moment of inertia of an rod about an axis passing through its center of mass or its geometrical center. So IC equals to, then integration m by L, it is the constant. So m by L, integration of, that is x square into dx, having the limits, that is minus L by 2 up to, that is the L by 2. Now the moment of inertia of the rod about an axis passing through its center and perpendicular to its length, it is given by IC equals to, that is capital M upon capital L. Now x square into dx, by using the formula of integration, that is integration of xn into dx equals to x raised to power n plus 1 upon, that is the power n plus 1. So x square, here it is power 2. So you can write like this, integration of, that is x square into dx, it is nothing but, that is x cube. So 2 plus 3, that means x cube upon, that is the 3. So you get this one, that is m by L, integration of this one, x square into dx, it is x cube upon 3, and having the limits, that is minus L by 2 up to, that is the plus L by 2. Now the moment of inertia of this rod, that is IC equals to this 3, it is constant. So m upon 3L and integration, that is the x cube having the limits minus L by 2 up to, that is the plus L by 2. Now in place of x, we have to put the upper limits and that is the lower limits. So by using the formula or by simplifying this, we can write like this, that is IC equals to m upon 3L, and in case of x, what is the upper limit? That is L by 2. So L by 2 cube minus lower limit, that is minus L by 2 its cube. Now placing the values of upper limit and lower limit in place of x, we have this one, and therefore IC equals to, that is m upon 3L in bracket L cube upon 8 plus, that is L cube upon 8, then we have the relation, that is m upon 3L, so 2L cube upon, that is the 8. Now we can write like this, this is the 4, and we can write like this, IC equals to m, that is the L cube upon, that is 12L, and therefore we can finally write like this, that is the moment of inertia of a rod about an axis passing through the center and perpendicular to its length, that is IC equals to, so L and this L get cancelled, so m L square upon 12, and this is the relation for, that is the moment of inertia of this rod about this axis. Okay, now suppose we are going to change the axis of rotation. Now the axis is here, axis is here, now the rod is moving about this axis. Again, this is the axis which is perpendicular to the length and passing through its one end. Now these two axes are parallel to each other. So in this case, if we want to calculate the moment of inertia of this thin and uniform rod about an axis passing through its one end and perpendicular to its length, then we have to use the parallel axis theorem. So for this purpose, if the axis of rotation, it is passing through its one end, then according to the parallel axis theorem, we have the relation, that is IO equals to, that is IC plus, that is m x square. This is the relation for parallel axis theorem. So IC, it is the moment of inertia of this rod, that is about an axis passing through its center, and IO, it is the moment of inertia of this rod about an axis passing through its one end. So on putting the values, and x square, it is the distance between two parallel axes. And what is the x? That is x equals to capital L by 2. So on putting these values, we can determine the moment of inertia of this rod about this axis, and we have the relation for that, that is IO equals to IC, it is the value for IC, m L square upon 12 plus, that is m, and x square, it is the length, it is the distance, perpendicular distance between two parallel axes. So that is the L by 2 its square. Now we can write like this, moment of inertia IO equals to m L square upon 12 plus m L square upon 4. Now by equalizing the bases, we can write like this, that is IO equals to moment of inertia of the rod about an axis passing through its one end, it is given by IO equals to, that is m L square upon, that is the 12, now plus 3 m l square. So 3 m l square. Now on equalizing the bases, we can write like this, so m l square plus 3 m l square upon, that is the 12, and now IO equals to, that is 4 m l square upon, that is the 12, and therefore IO equals to, that is m l square upon, that is the 3. So this is the relation for moment of inertia of the rod about an axis passing through its one end. So IC, it is having the value ml square upon 12, and IO, it is having the value, that is ml square by, that is the 3. So in this way we can determine the moment of inertia of a given rod about an axis passing through its geometrical center or passing through its center of mass, and the axis, it is perpendicular to its length. And also we can determine the moment of inertia of this rod about an axis passing through its one end. Thank you.